Green Bay, Wisconsin for Friday Night Magic. Game one, we have Corey on Bantrank and Andrew on Blue Black Mill. This tournament is going to be a best of four. Andrew decides to take the play. Watergate shocked. And a Graph Digger's Cage turn one. Temple of Mystery from Corey, scrying. Playing it to the bottom. Swamp Pass. Appears he's holding up Heartless Act, or the new rogue printed out of M21. Temple of Plenty from Corey. If he keeps it on top, it's a good time to play the rogue, but he's just shipping it to the bottom again. Corey mills two, hits a Joriel, and flash another one. He's going to mill four. Scrap Digger's Cage looking good. Protection from Oro, at least. Swinging here for two. Drops Corey to 18. Sacrificing failed passage on his turn. Finding a tap land. Toriel. One more card until these rogues are 3/2s. Corey drops down to 16. Another Scryland. Yep. I'm assuming it's a land on top. He kept that pretty quick. Corey goes up to 19. Oro goes to the graveyard. And he puts this Temple Garden off the top into play. Fairy's Tutelage, going to draw a discard from Leisner and mill Corey too. Discarding a Heartless Act. Swinging for six. Corey drops to 13. decisions from Korra. I believe he's just thinking about Elspeth Conqueror's death, this Teferi's tutelage right away. But he may go for something else. Yep. Probably the right call here. So Grafdigger's cage stops creatures from entering the battlefield, but Korra has at least a baby Teferi in his graveyard, so he always has that as an option for Elspeth Conqueror's death. Mana here, it looks like. Yep. Oh, 7 mana. Hydro Crisis for 5. Korra's going to gain 2, draw 2 here, going up to 9. Moving the draw, that's pretty good. Shock the Scry on top. And no attacks here. I believe the thieves have Death Touch. A little surprising. Korra does not know there's a Planeswalker in his graveyard, I guess. Decides to not bring back anything. Actually, does he have to bring back something? He has to return something, but he, by just choosing not to, I guess he could target a creature and it just fizzles because of Grafdigger's cage. That definitely seems like a misplay. Posting Nissa Who Shakes the World, turning an island into a 3/3. Hydroid Crisis for 5 here. He is going to gain another 2 life and draw another 2 cards. Ashiok. Corey's gonna mill 4 and enter his graveyard. Ugin is looking kind of juicy here. Swing for. Could swing for 13. I'm just slamming Ugin. Minus 3. He would lose his Crisis, but he'll have an Ugin. His opponent has 2 cards. Mana for a baby Teferi. It's going to be an Ugin here. Minus 1, just removing Lyser's blockers. Probably better than minus 3. We're at 16 damage here, not bad. Put Leisner down to 2. Just kind of playing if he wants to hit Ashiok. If he can lose from this point. She bounced Ashiok. That's an illegal move. And you caught it right away. Alright, well, that's gonna scoop it up. Corey's gonna take game one. Judge question on the floor. I will be right back. And I am back. Players are just sideboarding out for the next game. Looks like players sideboarded pretty quickly. That's nice, at least. So, some miscommunication here. Gotta go say, gotta correct it real quick. So a Temple of the Seed Scry from Leisner, and then a Fabled Passage, turn one, from Coriolis. it is just me, Jamie, because you're not here and neither is P-Core. No, there was a confusion in between cyborging. Leisner referenced extinction event, and he said it was even as their odds on it was just exile even or odd permanence, non-land permanence. And I had to go in there just to correct that it's specifically creatures and not permanence. Yeah, P-Core, he had to call in from his other job today because he was feeling awful. So I'm solo for now, sadly. Unless you want to come to Green Bay. Yeah, hopefully. The mystical dispute from Corey countering the Unborn Ego is pretty clutch. Ashiok, followed by another mystical dispute. What a sideboard card. Mystical dispute's too good. Scryland from Corey. We kept it on top. Ashiok's primarily there. He's just a mill strategy, but I think it's primarily for Uro. I mean, it also stops people looking from lands, I guess, but I think it's just Uro. Because they exile the graveyard afterwards, after the mill four. Six mana here. Hydroid Crisis for four. Resolves. Corey's going to draw two, gain two, and then it resolves. Swing for four. Heartless Act to remove three counters from it. Leisner takes one. This sort of shakes the world. Turning this forest into a 3/3. So this Nissa just looking to win the game. Like, how much could a maximum hybrid crisis be? 2, 4, 5, 6, 8, 9, 10, 12. So it could be a 10-10 draw 5, gain 5. Well, I guess it could even be a 12-12 if you wanted. Oh, yeah. Crisis for 6. God. Hydroid Crisis rotating will make me really happy, honestly. Blessing Nissa, targeting Temple Garden. Yeah. Crisis and Nissa seem boring powerful, that's true. They just like enable themselves, which is like an annoying strategy. But yeah, once rotation happens, I don't know. It's really going to be the Wild West. You lose so much. Lava Madness. A classic deck. The shiny blue card is Teferi's Tutelage. It's like Sphinx's Tutelage almost, but it's a 3 mana. When it enters the battlefield, draw discard, and then whenever you draw a card, your opponent mills 2. End of turn, Corey's gonna make a 4/4 shark. This is just gonna be lethal here. Corey has lethal on board. He's just BMing. Oh, he wants maximum damage. That's gonna be like a swing for like 40. Well, Corey gets there. Pretty solid. Leisner had a decent amount of interaction too. It's just when you get so much value off of just casting your cards. Like, it's hard to keep up with when you have, like, 1-for-1 removal. But that's life. See you guys in the next round. Hello, we are back with round 2 of Friday Night Magic. We have Tyler on Team Lore Super Friends and Tyson on Team Lore Reclamation. Tyson's keeping. And Tyler's keeping as well. Fable Passage, the land draw from Tyson. Steam vents from Tyler. Looks like a Rada in Tyler's hand. That's kind of spicy. Haven't seen anyone really use it yet. End of turn, Growth Spiral. Steamout's tapped. Does Tyson have the Reclamation? He does. trying to pass. Throw a spiral. Play a land, dies. Draw a spiral. Draw a spiral gets mystical disputed. Cultivate. X is 4 for this Shark Typhoon. Swinging 4 in the air. Stop a ground tapped, Sarkhan, Masterless. It's been a minute. Negate it. He is going to scry with Castle Vantress. Swinging for 10. So Tyler's at 6, I believe. The dice are off the table. I'll tell him to put them on after this round. I'll just zoom out a bit just to... Whoop, 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 whoop. There we go. Two blue, a red, and a green. Explosion for 6. That'll be a quick game 1. Tyler declaring he'll be on the play going into game 2. Sideboarding. Both players seem like they know what they're bringing in already. Both players down the sideboard and shuffling up. Boreal Grazer land, and then an island from Tyson and a pass. Boreal Grazer, probably the best start from Tyler. He swings for 0-2. Sign of disrespect. Tyson shocking a breeding pool, and Tyler playing a scooze. Swinging for 0 again. Gross borrow from Tyson. Steve Vincent to play tapped. That plan, that's probably a good sign for Tyler. No rec on 4. Swinging for 2. Looks like Tyler's stuck on 3 here. Unfortunate. Finally gets mana, but this dispute's gonna get whatever he does. Oh, should do start tops. That counter won't do anything. To do shark and block. Uro. Oh, Mu Yang Li the draw. How did a fire artisan negate? Still no wreck. Growth Spiral. Just Expansion Explosion. Big damage. Tyson drops down to 9. was supposed to kill it. Oro, Tyson will go up to 12, draw a card, play an additional land, or put a land into play. Growth Spiral. Growth Spiral. Cannot find lands. Oh no. So many redraws. Dispute it. This who shakes the world? Neutralize it. Yeah, that's rough. I think this basically seals it up. Shark for four. Okay, yep. Tyler's gonna be scooping it up. Sadly, the mana got stuck both games. Sadly, not the best game, but sometimes Team Reclamation just has everything. So we'll be back with the next round shortly. It's actually been going pretty fast. Everybody got done with like 15 minutes a round last round, so see you soon. Hello, we're here with round 3 of Standard. It looks like both players keep. Clint will play a Stepping Ground. Yep. Clint's on Red Green Mutate, and Matthew's on Blue Flash. Another Stepping Ground tapped. Swing one with the Petramander. And a four is no plays. That yellow, that is literally what Matthew said. Scary Terry. An octopus. Swing two, and Matthew's gonna draw a card. Gonna counter it unless Clint pays four. Special Sailor. Two and three in the air. Matthew will draw another card and pass. There's been a lot of counter spells on camera. I don't think I'm about it. Bone Crusher. Attempting to target the octopus.
Matthew will attempt to counter unless he pays three, and Clint will pay three. Swinging two in the air. The Teferi is a pretty good play here. Garuk. It resolves. Matthew gonna loot at the end of Clint's turn. Swinging at Clint for six. Clint falls down to six. Looks like two Brazen Barrows in hand. It looks like Matthew has it wrapped up this turn. Fairy drops down to four. Matthew's going to get their game one. A lot of counter spells tonight.
Clint is going to be on the play.
Having grounds untapped, a Boreal Grazer. Island for Matthew. Grazer. Special Sailor. Looks like a Center of Vines in Clint's hand. Trying to get some chip damage in. I'm assuming this Paradise Druid's gonna come into play. I think that's too good not to. Hexproof is pretty solid. These grazers are gonna block the octopus perfectly though, so that's good. Brian Hart or Brian Cut Purse is gonna feel bad. Yeah, I was gonna say I don't think there's really a decision to make. Cycle Godzilla. Put a trample counter on his O3. I like it. Turn another sailor. Sea Dasher on him. Blue Flash just seems so good against these, like, big mana strategies. I don't think Matthew has a problem with Cinder Vines at all, right? I mean, just like, it's gonna do barely any damage. But Aethergust. Clint puts it to the bottom. And I don't think Aethergust really does anything there. Or,
Sorry, Cinder Vines. Matthew would have to cast 20 spells. Solid attack here. Clem will take 6 and draw, and Matthew will draw a card. Land. That means the stairs can come down on the Paradise Druid. But it looks like Matthew might have a quench in hand. There might be a world to just Gem Razor the Paradise Druid. Yep, I'm raising the Paradise Druid. That seems good. 4/4 with reach. Matthew's big thinking. Matthew is big thinking. I'm going to play an octopus on a spectral sailor and untap. I don't know how much I like that play. That can't really get through. Probably would have just put another octopus on the octopus that already exists, honestly. I feel like it's a pretty solid block to just block the arboreal grazer, the big one, and then block the 2/2 with the gem razor. That's weird. Just blocking one from Clint. I think he thinks that that octopus has the brine effect because he was worried about Matthew casting more. Oh, lands the draw. Asterisks are nothing here. Counter lets you pay 2. Clint can pay 2 here. Oh. Tries to bounce, but it has hexproof. Two permanents. Maybe an Ugin? No Ugin. Oh, that's heartbreaking. I think that pretty much seals it up. Very quick games today. I think it really was Ugin or Bust there. I know Clint plays 4. Clint will take 5, falling to 4.
pass. I mean, I hope Clint gets his. Oh, he needed to mutate. That's game. I was so surprised Matthew didn't bounce that creature while he had the chance. But, yep, Matthew gets there in two. We'll be back shortly with the fourth and final round. Thank you. Hello. We are back with the fourth and final round. We have Corey, who we saw round one, and Matthew, we just saw last round, the only undefeateds. Corey will win the dice roll, and Alex to play first. Oh, you're talking, huh? But, yep, should be a good game. It should be a quick one. Like, we've only had one round go to time so far. Corey says he's good to keep. Breeding pool tapped. Island for Matthew. Breeding pool shock. Joriel. Probably one of the best draws for Corey this early. Or one of the best plays, at least. Corey can apply pressure just by playing his normal hand. And, like, if Matthew has a counter for any of these things, like, he's not doing anything of his own. Planes into play tapped. Growth spiral, hopefully. Oh, he just passes? That's not the best. Swing with Grind Deep Cutthroat or Cut Purse. Oro. Mystical Dispute. Ooh, that looks like a myth play from Matthew. I think he has another Cut Purse in his hand. That was a free block if he. I mean, Corey wouldn't have attacked, but I mean, I don't know if that was correct. You're just, like, applying so much pressure on board by having two of those. Uro. Counter unless Corey pays four. Top bet swing seven. Corey drops out of five. Looks like it's all about wrapped up. Scry? Pass. Tape. See the Asher Octopus on the Spectral Sailor. Trigger on the Bright Deep Cutthroat. Combat. Corey attempts to make a 1-1 and cycle. Most likely it gets bounced here by Matthew. And that will be game one. Right under 4 minutes. Very nice, like, Delver strategy from the Blue Flash player. Like, Brian Deep Cut Purse is just so solid. That's another card that's going to be rotating, which is probably a good thing. I think the power level of Standard overall is just going to come down slightly without like, Ravnica Block and some few other sets. Fairy in the hand for Corey, but that's going to be a mulligan. It's not good. I'm assuming Matthew brought in like every mystical dispute he had in the sideboard. We'll keep and put one to the bottom. It's a Blue of Enlightenment. Scry. Chip it to the bottom. It looked like it might have been a Teferi, but I think Corey's too light on lands. Terramander. Fable Passage from Corey. Swing and one. Corey drops on a 19. That was a growth spiral he shipped to the bottom.
ferry. The gate. Sarah Amanda. 22, Corey falls on the 16. Big old passage. Oro. Mystical dispute. Corey passes turn. Mutate the octopus. Swing three at Corey. Corey drops down to 13. Matthew draws a card. Either gets the draw. Then Corey has to hope this. He hits a land off the top and can cycle the Shark Typhoon for three. Try the sky. Counter. Corey has tried to make three plays and everyone's been countered so far. Huh, another counter spell to draw. Three of Corey drops onto 10. Spectral Sailor the draw. And the pass. Special Sailor. Goes to Corey's turn. Not everything Corey's done has just been countered. Like, even this Shark Typhoon is going to be theoretically countered by this Brazen Borrower. Four box bounce. Corey's gonna draw, fall down a six here. Corey like needs a Shy of the Sky, but even if he hits it, Matthew has a counter spell. Hydroid Grace is the draw.
there's just like nothing Corey can do. This should be lethal. Oh, he has all four of the lofty denials. But, yep. Not a super interesting one, but quick games. Well, everybody, thank you for watching. We'll be back tomorrow with, we have a Pioneer Winnet box, actually, so hopefully we get a decent amount of players for that one. Thank you very much.